I heard there was a an opening. No, but I went on tour with George Gershwin before that. I auditioned to go out, and Gershwin went on tour and toured for about 8 weeks. And we played, he played the concerto, the Rhapsody, Concerto in F, Rhapsody in Blue, the preludes, the third piece for the piano. An American in Paris, that's it.
What was he like at that time?
It was fun, we went on tour. We slept, we had our own railroad car, because those days, that's the way you travel. And so we'd leave our stuff, we'd go on a siding, and they put us on a siding, and we'd get off, and our stuff would be there, and we'd had a berth there, and we'd go to the hall, do the concert, and then get back on the train and go to sleep, and some during the night they'd hitch us up and take us to the next city.
What about working with Gershwin himself?
It's very simple. He's a very quiet, relaxed, wonderful, everyone says this version, that version, everyone says, plays these player piano versions. I play with him every night. I know the version he played. He played the Rudy Greffet arrangement of Rhapsody in Blue, because Rhapsody in Blue is nothing more than a piano improvisation with orchestral interludes. And George was doing a show in Boston, and Paul Whiteman was doing this concert at Aeolian Hall, American composers. He had Copland and Gershwin and God knows who else. Whiteman asked him, and he got with Rudy Greffet, and he played all these piano parts, and Rudy Greffet took these piano parts and used them as interludes, and that became Rhapsody in Blue. The opening clarinet solo was a chromatic, and there was a marvelous musician named Ross Gorman, and he had a trick with the clarinet where he made the glissando. So he was the one who started. He'd start with a trill, then go. And that's how it's set. That's how the tradition. That's what they call tradition. Somebody has an idea, then it takes hold, then it becomes tradition.